Vargis, hi Vargis. So there's 17 participants. Should we give it another minute or two? It's Saturday morning after all.
Yes.
Yeah, people are joining in now. Hi Raghuram, Sonu.
Sonu, were you in Sun? Sonu Malhotra.
So I'll just go ahead and just get started with the intro as we wait for folks to join in, and in a couple of minutes, Manjula will start. So welcome everyone to the first session of the Leadership Success Series. This is the Senior Manager and Director track, but we thought this session on personal branding is very relevant and useful to everybody. So all are invited. Hope you're going to enjoy this. Manjula is a great speaker. She's a professor at Srishti College, and I'll let her introduce herself a little later. So just a few housekeeping things. We will be muting everybody on entry, but if you want to speak, there's going to be lots of interactivity for no Manjula sessions. Feel free to put your message on chat, or you can unmute yourself and speak, as the case may be. This session is by Manage the Docs, which is an initiative of TWIN, Technical Writers of India. This will be on the second Fridays of every month. The first Fridays we have the Entrepreneur Track, which is run by Leanne, and the third Fridays is the Aspiring and Firstline Manager Track, which is run by Asha. So, excuse me. The first three Fridays we have sessions, 10 to 11. Only today it's an exception on Saturday to accommodate Manjula, because she teaches, and she has classes during the week. So very thankful that she's made time to be here. About the series itself, if you attend five complete sessions and fill in the feedback form at the end, then you do get a certification from TWIN. So only if you attend the live sessions, and we will be tracking that. We want to take this opportunity to thank Cisco, who's the platform sponsor for this entire series, for both the tracks, the senior managers as well as the managers track. So thank you, Cisco, and for all the folks who are helping us here, Anu for hosting it, and I see that Vineet and Manju are co-hosting. So thanks very much for taking care of those formalities. So yes, with that, I think we have about 28 people are still joining in, but we can go ahead and get started. I'll hand over the floor to Manjula. So take it away, Manjula.
Thank you, Sandy, for that lovely introduction. And it's wonderful to see so many people, and it brings me back a lot of good memories. And thank you for giving me this opportunity to take this session. Personally, Akimbo. The man is standing, but it has nothing to do with the gender. I just found this picture nice, and it looks like an A, so I just put it up there. So I can have the next slide, please, Anu, and thank you for manning this, taking care of the slides. Helpful for me. Yep, that's me goofing off in Greece. This mugshot is not always common with me, because in Greece, I still remember I was frowning more than smiling. Because there was a lot of walking and a lot of sunshine and heat. But this picture was taken in Meteora in Greece, which is a beautiful monastery built sometime in the 14th century. It's interesting to note that the Greeks actually started building their monasteries on hills, atop hilltops, because of fear of the Turkish invasion. And it's really beautiful and scenic place with smile in a way. Yeah. I teach at
Manchika, just breaking
Institute
up a little bit, your voice.
Design and Technology.
Sorry.
And I moved on from the industry. My skills, which is, can you hear any? Hello? Can you hear me? Can anyone tell me?
You're breaking up a bit, Manjula, and we can hear you now, but you're breaking up.
I think it's the internet. I'll try and speak
Yeah.
as loudly and as close to the mic as possible.
Yeah, this is clear now. Thanks.
Okay, bear with me if I pick up a bit in once. Just let me know. Yeah, so Srishti Manipal Institute of Art, Design and Technology is a place where a lot of design innovations and inventions take place. And it's a very vibrant place. And I learned that I actually be there and I actually teach writing and a little bit of biology. Slide, Anu, please. May I have the next slide? So a talk on personal branding, but I will try to introduce concepts. And you know, it's much more than just an hour, but we'll try and do something in a very interactive and fun way. So the questions are really, what is personal branding? And why you look at personal branding today in today's world, why personal branding seems to be going hand in hand with corporate branding, actually, which started much earlier, and how you might want to do this, personal branding for your own, in your own manner and in your own unique manner, I would like to add. So this slide deck, this talk will be more on these three questions. Feel free to interrupt when you feel I having a question on your own, and I'll try and answer it and keep to time as much as possible. May I have the next slide?
We can't hear you, Manjula.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Jeff Bezos said once that what people say about you when you're not in the room is actually personal branding. It makes a lot of sense. Oh, I'm being myself. Can you hear me now? Hello?
Hello? It's breaking up quite a lot.
Shall I get another? I'll get another
ear.
A different internet connection? Okay.
Right.
Okay, let me try.
Maybe as suggested, maybe you can just switch off a video for some time, Manjula, and see if that works. Maybe. I'm not sure.
Okay, while Manjula is getting her internet connectivity sorted out, I hope you all have white sheets of paper and color pencils. That was Manjula's request, I suppose, for one of exercise. So if you don't have it, this is a good time to go and grab it and come back so that you'll be able to participate. I had to go and borrow from my daughter's table. She's still sleeping. So yeah, I just picked it up from there. For those who are just joining, Manjula was having some internet issues and is just joining back.
Can you hear me better now?
Yes, we can hear you right now.
I've used another internet connection, so I hope that this will work better.
Okay, go for it.
I'm so sorry. So what were we talking about? Yes, we were talking about the what Jeff Bezos said once upon a time, that what people say about you when you're not in the room is essentially personal branding. That's only a part. But yes, it's true. I mean, you know, people do tend to say, you know, somebody speaks well, but, you know, he's a good team player, but, and the but doesn't come until, you know, they move through. But still stop us from may I have the next slide, please? Okay, here's a small exercise for you all. And I just want you to see if you want to name your favorite brand. And at least one of these. I mean, it could be a car, it could be a motorbike, it could be a phone, or it could even be something you love eating, like pizza. So just name your favorite brand and give a couple of reasons as to why you think that you like that brand a lot. I'll give you about 3 minutes to do this. Any questions? Vineet, do you have something? I hope you can. Sandhya, yeah. Samson.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Good point.
So I think others can also type in the chat window, you know, brands that you associate with these pictures and why.
Yes. You can even use all of them, but then I leave it to you. Just one or two reasons why you think that a brand is calling out to you. Absolutely. Innovation. Yes, that's my name is thy name is Apple. Royal Enfield. Wow. Do you like it, Andini? Okay. That's up for Yamaha. Wow.
Okay. Sorry, Manjula. Do you want to switch off your video? The sound might be better.
Okay. Okay. Done. Yes, makes more sense. I've stopped the video. Can you hear me better now?
Yes.
Okay, I keep my fingers crossed. Nima, yes, Nima, you love big cars. I know that. Okay, so these are a few of your favorite things. Now, let me ask you another question. Yes, Vineet, I know you love Apple, yes. Can I go to the next slide? Can you go to the next slide, please? All right. So here we're looking at people. So look at who comes to your mind when you think of a world leader or a thought leader, a CEO or an entrepreneur, any of the three or all the three. And why do you think that that person comes to you right away when you think? So don't think too much. Just quickly think of a few names and put them on chat. Steve Jobs, yeah, absolutely. Elon Musk now, yes. Absolutely. Kiran Mazum, yeah, Sandhya, I totally agree with you. Wonderful lady. Oprah, yes, absolutely. I think she's more of a leader, yes. Sonam Wangchuk, absolutely. Some name, that's Ratan Tata. Why do you think these names come up in your mind when you think of world leaders or CEOs or entrepreneurs? Can anyone quickly just speak up? I mean, unmute and talk about why you thought that, you know, immediately that person came into your mind, like Steve Jobs or Oprah Winfrey or a CEO, maybe even Ratan Tata. Yes, yes, absolutely. JRD Tata. Why do you think so? Can anyone just unmute and tell me? Or use the chat? Yes.
My choice is Larry Ellison, because I like his charismatic personality. And one of the reasons that I was in Oracle for close to
Oracle. Yeah.
So because of him, I know that I won't be able to interact with him or something like that. But still, I like to be in the company that he founded. So that was one of the reasons that I joined the company itself. Yeah. Because of the leader.
You never know. You may interact with him, Surak. So don't.
I'm no longer working there. But yeah, in the future.
Okay, even then.
Yeah.
Yes, yes. So something about these people. Anybody else would like to pipe in before I say something? I mean, anyone else who really wants to say something?
I am in awe of Oprah Winfrey. The reason is that she talks about topics sometimes which are taboo in our society, and she talks about them very openly, and she brings a very real perspective in every conversation that she has on her show. So that to me is really impressive.
Absolutely. I think she's very bold and, like you said, very rightly, you know, brings topics that are taboo and still brings it and communicates it in such a way that I think her USP is absolutely communication and understanding body language. So, you know, people are role models. They become role models because of their own brand, you know, the brand that they bring to the table. And it's not that it happens overnight, perhaps, but it probably happens with time. But it stays in your mind. So JRD, absolutely visionary, humane. So it's not just entrepreneurship. And sometimes world leaders may be entrepreneurs and they may mesh in their roles. But essentially what happens when you think of a personal brand is you look at them as role models, and they stick somewhere in your mind for various reasons, right? So while we had corporate brands for a long time, now personal brands are becoming really the order of the day. And sometimes they even mesh with the company that you work in. So something about people will make you feel that, you know, you need to showcase your talent, or you need to showcase that particular skill that you have built. So so many things can come into personal branding, like your oratorial skills or your empathy and compassion. Or pragmatism or dynamism or a mix of qualities. So why do we need a personal brand? Have you ever thought of that? Is it always to come up in your career? No, perhaps not. Because sometimes you may want to become a thought leader in a niche area. So when somebody talks of, let's say, palliative care, for instance, you know, Elizabeth Kubler-Ross would come into your mind, or Atul Gawande would come into your mind, because they have created a niche of understanding palliative care in a different way altogether. So is healing always important, or is mind healing important? So they become thought leaders, and that's something you may want to grow into. And you bring with you trust and credibility. So that's why when you looked at a brand, like a corporate brand, you say Yamaha, or you say Apple, or you say Samsung, because that has created a trust in you. And you trust that brand. Or you may want to become an entrepreneur. And if you want to become an entrepreneur, personal branding is a bedrock for the further branding that you're going to do for your company. Or you may want to show that you are the best candidate for the job. And, you know, the resume speaks, definitely. But, you know, that dreaded question that you ask or you're asked as to, so tell me a little bit about yourself. How many of us have had that question put on us? I mean, you know, so the HR might sit back and say, okay, now tell me a little bit about yourself. And then you start wondering. And then I heard people say things like, basically, I'm from Hyderabad. Basically, I'm an engineer. So a lot of this is already there in your resume, right? So I may not want to really hear you say the same thing again and again. So you have to say something that makes you really unique. And why is it that you are the best candidate for the job, perhaps? So, you know, to be assertive in a way in which you are trying to project your skills rather than say something which is already said or which is already written about. But so how do you do that? You can do it through various ways, and that takes a little bit of practice and skill. So you may also want to re-evaluate and reassess your skills and strengths sometimes. From time to time, we tend to do that. We tend to start thinking back and saying, okay, I'm here right now, but is it that I want to be here all the time, or do I want to do something a little different because something has struck me as very interesting? So re-evaluating and reassessing your skills and strengths often happens, and we will look into that a little bit in the, you know, the next few slides. Or the other thing is relocating to your dream. Why not, right? So many times we have dreams of going to places or working in sunny atmospheres or, you know, by the sea and or in some other place other than Bangalore, perhaps. So look at it, I mean, in a positive way and say, how can you improve yourself? Or how can you reinvent yourself so that you can reach your dreams? And you work towards it, right? Any comments on this while we move to the next slide? So while Anu is going to move to the next slide, I just wanted to tell you one more thing. In that, you know, many times you can become a brand ambassador, but that is the next step to personal branding. So when you think of a product, you think of a person behind it, right? So that's how people grow, because the credibility and trust grows. And as that grows, you can, you know, move into the next notch, which is probably corporate branding of your entrepreneurial branding, or becoming a brand ambassador. So right now, just a little bit of thinking or reflecting on a piece of paper, write down the qualities that you truly believe you have. And I'm not talking about I do a lot of Java coding, or I'm really into data, and I'm great information architect, wonderful. All these I respect and honor. But for now, just look at the qualities that you have and you want to believe in that you have. That might grow into something later. So just think, just for a minute. So you can put it on chat, or you want to speak about it, you can speak about it also.
So is it like the soft skills that we have, Manjula?
Yes, it can be soft skills. It can be anything. It can be craft. It can be art. It can be music. Okay. You know, many times we put all these in a different compartment altogether and forget about them and put it in a lock and key. Mm-hmm. It never comes to the fore. So just think, because, you know, just look at yourself and say, what have you really, what in you has made people go, ah? I mean, you may doodle, you may draw, you may paint, and all these things are kept inside your psyche, but deep psyche, and don't come out at all. So let's try to pull them out. Many times we hide our talents, you know, I don't know why, but we tend to underplay them. So let's just put that and just feel free to, yes, Sandhya, communicate. Yes, I it goes away, the chat goes away. I just want to put it back on. Yes, communicator, leader, writer, poet, vlogger. Yes, I've seen your vlogs. Wonderful. And yeah, so that that's really at the core. Can anyone else talk about your qualities? Feel free. Feminist, poet, learner. Look at the number of things that are coming out, you know. Look at, just see the numbers. Integrity, belief, perseverance, creative. Creative, very, very important. So you may later on, you know, prioritize and say, what is it that you really have among these skills? What is it that really is blossoming right now? Anyone else wants to speak on this? Empathy, so important. We put it inside our deeper pockets. Why? Passionate, articulate, responsible. Empathy is very important, especially if you're a designer, or even if you're a writer, right? Because unless you empathize or you have patience with your customers or your people who are going to read your manuals or, you know, web pages, how are you going to even know what they want? So empathy is essentially putting yourself in the other person's shoes after you remove your own shoes, right? Musician, so spiritual, these are so important and we just tend to hide them. So try to see what, finding the needle in the haystack. I love that. So what does it mean, Anindita, finding the needle in the haystack? Can you just elaborate a little bit?
Yeah, it's finding, getting to the point when there's a lot of fluff floating around, finding the actual point or the needle, right, in all of that, you know, confusion.
So focusing on the actual problem per se, that's your real
finding strong the
point.
Problem. I mean, even before we can focus, we need to know, yes, what exactly we are trying to focus on. So getting to
Absolutely. The. Yes, very true. Because otherwise there's a lot of work, talk, gibberish, but nothing really comes out of it. Solutions, you cannot seek solutions without actually pinpointing the problem on hand. Absolutely. Listening, very, very important. Good listening, and you know, I can't underplay that. It's so important as managers, as leaders. Many times, you know, we tend to speak more than we listen. Very, very good qualities. Okay, so keep these in mind, and you know, start looking at what really is your USP in that sense, right? Don't ignore these qualities. If I have the next slide. So when you're looking deep within, what are you doing? You're actually starting, you're asking yourself, what drives me? What motivates me? In what areas do I excel? Now here you can also have your skills, right? Your domain, your skills. All these, you know, have a pattern and they may come together and mix and match, and then you get yourself a new role. In what areas do I excel? Because that is what I would like to hard sell. Right? So if I'm a good listener, jolly well, I'm going to be a great manager in many ways, because listening is one skill. It's just very hard to acquire. It is a practice. So if I'm that, then you can tell a story about how you listen to someone so well that you actually found what the deeper problem was. Because many times people tell us in a very superficial way. But when you really probe with probing questions and clarifying questions, you find that you get much better answers. Do you see that? So what work drains my energy? I put that in red because that is something that we sometimes need to sit up and look, because we are following the same pattern. We are doing the same thing, but something is really making us, you know, weak in our energy. So what is draining me? And sometimes it's good to know, then you need to avoid those situations that drain your energy and walk away from them sometimes. But what work fuels me? So these things are really reflective questions that you can ask yourself to build your personal brand, because then you sieve out the real information from the fluff and see what you really are. It distills out your personal brand. What settings do I work best in? I mean, I was just talking to Anu and I said, your garden is so beautiful. And that's a dream that she said, she wants to grow the garden like that. So I may want to work in my own settings in where I have a beautiful garden. Why not? In today's world, where everything is linked through the internet, and unfortunately sometimes which is choppy like mine, doesn't matter. The fact is that what really, do you like to stare at a white wall, or do you want to, you know, have some plants around you, or you want to have music? All these things matter to your personal brand. And what industries do I find interesting? So a lot of things like healthcare and manufacturing and design, they're all coming up with innovative ways to attract people into those domains. So you may look at some other industry tomorrow, maybe 2 years down the line or 3 years down the line, and say that, well, I want to move to this and really explore it. Because exploring is a part of your mental and physical and spiritual, I may say, spiritual quest, right? And what sets me apart from others? How? Because all of us have unique qualities, but many times we underplay them. So looking at yourself and seeing what sets you from the others is an important question that we mustn't really ignore, right? Or put away. Okay. Any questions so far? Or any comments?
Just a quick reminder, Manjula, we're halfway through the session. Yeah, thanks.
Yes. Yes. Thank you, Sandy. Okay, next slide, please.
Sorry, I was speaking on mute, Manjula. I just have like a question. You're probably going to cover it in future slide. If you are, it's fine. But, you know, there is also the aspect of being genuine or authentic, right, as part of, you know, your personal brand.
Yes.
Can you tell more, probably elaborate?
I think I will go to that. Yes. I think I will go into that, but I think being authentic and genuine is also a subset of being building trust and faith. Because when you're genuine you're congruent with what you speak and what you think, that brand itself sets itself apart. Your brand sets itself apart because people then look at you and say, yes, this is you're capable of delivering that, right? Mm-hmm.
Yep.
So let me maybe I will have more clarity as we move on. Okay, next slide, please. Yes, another important thing is, what do others see in me? I know that many of us do I forgot the HR name for it, if anybody remembers. It's a matrix where you see what I see in myself, what others see in me, what I don't see in myself, and what others do not see in me. I mean, if anybody remembers the name of that methodology, it's a bit of that. I mean, you know, what do others see in me is also an important question for personal branding. Because unless you know that, you can't see where you are, you know, you're lacking or where your strengths are also. 360 degree feedback, yes, that could be, but there's another name for it. I got a senior moment here, so I can't remember. But I will try and remember that. SDI, new word for me, but yes, so this is also important. If we may move to the next slide. So this is something which you might want to look at later, because Johari's window. Yes, Surat, God bless you. Yes, that is what it is exactly. So personal branding by Dan Schwabel, you can just look at his portfolio. Very, very interesting. And you see the way he has projected himself, and it is genuine and authentic. I mean, if he says 2,190 articles published, I dare say that there would be that number, right? If you put anything other than that, then your credibility goes down. But the simple way, he says, by the numbers, is one example when you say this personal branding. So those characteristics that make me unique and how I communicate to that to the world is something that Dan Schwabel has also mentioned. Yes, can I have the next slide? This is something that you might want to do a little later, but in the interest of time, as Sandy pointed out, it's like, you know, look at yourself the past year, because COVID has changed our lives to a great extent. But this is something that sometimes, you know, hardships and hard times sometimes get something in you to trigger off, and you start thinking on those lines. So look at this slide and see later on if you want to list out the past 12 months, what you saw in yourself as changing. Maybe you became more patient. Maybe you learned cooking. Maybe you baked a lot, whatever it is. And also have two other columns. What was in my control? What was out of my control? And that might affect your personal branding, right? So this is something important, which I felt in today's world that we need to see, because sometimes hardships bring out the best in us, right? I don't want it to sound cliched, but I think there is some truth in it. So let's move on. Right, so what are my core values? Now, values are always underplayed in many things, because we look at vision, we look at a company's mission, but we don't really bother to see what their values are. So when you join a company, you look at the website, you look at the technology behind it, you look at their skills that they require, you look at the vision and mission, but you hardly look at what the core values are. And that's why it's important to see in yourself your North Star as to what are my core values. Do I believe in excellence? Do I want to inspire people? Am I enthusiastic enough to infectious? Is my enthusiasm infectious? Or am I altruistic in nature? Do I love challenges? Have I empathy? And am I a stable person? So all these things you might want to re-look at when, you know, in your own free time. And these also play into your personal brand. So it's not just skills. It's not just the ability to, you know, look at a problem solving, but it's also to do with your own core values that will affect your personal brand. Any questions on this? Because without values, we don't really have, I won't say moral compass, but I will say ethical compass, right? Do I want to have drive my company to profit at any cost? Or is it something that I would rather rethink and look at people and their families? Is it something that I say that this has to be done? Or do I look at the situation and I try to be flexible in certain ways? You know, these are things that you look at and try to, how do you build your company behind the values that you yourself nurture, right? So are employees like resources? Or do I look at the family also as a unit? For instance, I tell you a story. I think in the United States, doctors were overworked for a long time, and some tragedies happened that made hospitals rethink and say that they cannot have work for more than, interns cannot work for more than, let's say, 80 hours a week or whatever, because they had to rethink. So this is something that you might want to look at. Can I have the next slide, Anu? Storytelling is something which is really eye-catching. And, I don't say that it should be out of context. Like if somebody is in a hurry and trying to interview you and you say, so let me tell you a story, that might not be the best time to do that. So look at it from a contextual point of view, and you need to understand the conversation from a deeper way to actually start a storytelling session, right? But storytelling is now becoming a real art because that gets your person's attention. For instance, you know, if you are running a hospital or you want to sell a hospital in a sense that I'm not saying sell, but, you know, you want to show or promote a hospital, you might want to talk about case studies. And people are always interested to listen to somebody whose sugar levels went up to a certain number, and then they were brought down by this, and then they were able to, these were the symptoms that they had. It always, people empathize and resonate with stories of health, of organic eating, of sustainability. These are buzzwords today. So, you know, thinking of a story, because articulation is a great gift and you can hone it with practice. And that also can have an elevator pitch, like Leanne spoke last week or the week before about, you know, how to create an elevator pitch. So people sit up to listen to a story each time, every time. So these are something that we might do perhaps you can think of in a workshop. So look at stories that might tickle the funny bone, but tell it in a contextual manner and with deep empathy for the overall conversation at large, right? Anybody wants to pipe in or say something or write something? Feel free.
So Manjula, stories are really powerful. And as you rightly said, if spoken in the right context, can have a powerful impact on, everyone who's listening to that story. So, without going into the nitty gritties, I once wrote on my blog a story about abuse. And that story stuck with the CEO of a company in Switzerland. And this guy, his father was no more, and he was a World War II veteran. And to date, he was in therapy, and he had a very turbulent relationship with his father. And when his father died, he could not forgive his father. And he stumbled on my blog by chance, and he read my story, and then he came back and wrote a comment, and he said, Rahul, by sharing your story, there was a moment of redemption for him, and he could actually forgive his father. Wow. So that is when I realized that, what impact the power of words have on people. And it was a life experience for that person. Just by going through my own experience, and he felt that he could forgive and forget. So I truly get that, and I strongly recommend people to come up and start, even if it comes from a place of pain or agony or whatever that is. Feel free to share that with the world, and you'll see the world reciprocating in a way that is unimaginable.
Absolutely. That's really beautiful. If you can change or transform one person, that's such a beautiful thing, right? Yes, Asha wanted to say something. Thank you, Rahul, for that sharing. Else we'll keep it to the end, perhaps. We'll move to the next slide. Anu? Thank you. So now let's just look at what really comprises a personal brand. Well, signature also matters. When you look at somebody who scrawls a signature, you say, okay, I'm not saying much about, it doesn't say much about your personality, but sometimes beautiful signatures really kindle something in you, in the person who's reading it. And your profile picture, yeah. I'm not one to say, oh, you have to dress in a certain way, or you have to, wear the right kind of slippers. Although there were people, senior managers, who told me about somebody who came to the US wearing flimsy slippers, which I found rather, sad. But that is life, right? That is the world for you. So, looking at what really you are comfortable in is important. I must say that. I mean, many times we wear something which we feel is appropriate for that particular job or that, and they may have a dress code also, but also keep in mind what you are comfortable in. So if it's pant and shirt, and for the ladies, that's great. But if you feel better in kurtis, or you feel better in, short tops, that's good too. So look at yourself and don't, feel shy about saying, or I've seen people wearing lovely saris every day, and we used to admire that person working in the IT industry because, they were so elegant also. So thinking what you are comfortable in is very important. I'm not saying that this particular dress is great or that isn't. I'm not trying to do that. I'm just saying that look at yourself, how you are, and how you project yourself to the world. And it should, that also should be congruent with your true self. And sometimes, if you have a web page, you have a code, that's wonderful, something you truly believe in, or you can have a logo. Design thinking skills also teach you how to prepare a logo. And sometimes my students prepare beautiful logos on organic farming and things, but that is after a lot of mulling over keywords and important mind maps and things like that. So create your own website. And this is, unfortunately, I don't have the time to explain these things in this particular class, in this particular session, but having a good website makes you feel really nice and creative. And other social media presence, I can't underplay it. I mean, it's also very important whether you have a YouTube channel or whether you have Instagram presence. I don't know. I don't care how many followers. I'm not really into numbers, but that helps people remember you. That much I can tell you. Right? Okay. Can I have the next slide? Right. So this is where you need to really look at start looking at how to build your personal brand if you haven't done so already. And I'm sure many of you have. So finding your niche is important. And I have given a link here and other references that will help you look at Neil Patel's blog. Very, very interesting. How to create that SEO, you know, helping the SEO optimization and driving more traffic to increase visibility. Having keywords. And here you have, you know, how specific you want to go, how drilled down do you want to have your keywords, or how generic do you want them to be? And there's something called Uber Suggest. I really hope you can take a look at that. And remember one thing, that keywords may change because you evolve and change with time. But people do like consistency. That's it. You know, people like stability, people like consistency. Consistency. For instance, if Apple suddenly changes its UI, you might start feeling a little nervous or get a panic attack because that's not something you expect from Apple. So innovation has to go not only in a brand, but your own brand, but it has to meld with your persona, right? Any questions here? Or any comments? Okay, so may I move to the next slide? So this is just a little bit on how to explain your social media brand voice, how to create it. You can take a look at it more closely. Like for instance, you know, what is a character you want to portray, a persona? Are you friendly or playful? Are you warm? Are you authoritative? Are you inspiring? Are you professional? So what is it that you want to project and which you truly are? For instance, I can't be, I tend to be a little playful, and it can be a mix. I tend to be a little playful, a little warm, and a little bit professional. Maybe earlier when I was in the IT industry, I tried to be more professional, but now I have changed as a person. The tone also is important. Like, you want to be honest, like what Rahul explained to us about honesty and being personal. And we think being personal is something to be, to shy off, but no. Sometimes that can transform somebody, or that can really hit something in the person's mind and the aha moment comes up. So yes, so clinical, scientific. Are you to think with your mind, do you think with your heart, or do you think with both? So what about the language? Do I want simple language, or do I want it to be jargon filled, or do I have fun in my element in my personal brand? And what is the purpose? That's important. Who are my audience? I mean, who am I going to present myself, this personal brand, this website to? If I'm a professor, I may have a different kind of personal brand. But if I'm working as in an IT industry or any industry, my personal brand may be more different. It may be to engage. It may be to inform, to sell. So these things are a part of, to create your social media brand voice. And you need not have just one, you can have a combination, but it has to go with your actual true self. Okay, can I have the next slide, please? And any comments, please put it in chat, feel free. And we were talking about the logo, which you might want to consider for yourself or for your web page. There's something called the mood board that people in the design world use. It's a very beautiful visual tool that communicates your concepts and visual ideas. And it's a well thought out, you put a lot of images, material. In fact, I've seen people put wool. I've seen people put, material like designs on their mood board. And they're really beautiful because they have one wonderful font, color scheme. So create one in your room. That's what I think. You get inspired looking at it. Keep your eyes open. See what you want to add. You may want to remove something, but it's a wonderful way of creating your own, looking at your, visualizing your persona. Can I have the next slide, please? So this is just a way to make your mood board. So look at what you feel. These are the keywords. Show your style, reels in your stylings, whatever you are. Play, very important. Play and invent. And look at it, abstract it, distill it, create a logo. If you see, remember Mindtree and the way the logo was created by a little boy, I think it came very spontaneously. And it is a deep talent that the boy had. But many of us can't really think that spontaneously or think on our feet. So we need these tools sometimes to get us to think and sit up and look at what really vibrates in us, right? So create those images for yourself. Move the images around the board if you want. Create different compositions, right? Play around the images until you are happy with the images that you have. So you may draw, you may doodle, you may take photographs. Put them all up like a board and think and see how you can abstract from those images. Next slide, please, Anu. So here's just an example that I wanted to show you about this girl who is into printing, and Jake, yeah, that's his name. And just kept a simple mood board. So it can be black and white pictures, a small color in between, the font can be beautiful. So just, you know, play around with it, this kind of a mood board and see what it does to you. Yes, Anu, it's a wonderful team building activity. Look at the energy that it creates. No? So, you know, when you create a mood board, you have different things like craft. So here you have one part on the left side, which is just craft, which is a stitch. I think they're probably cross stitches or something. And then you have inspiration quote somewhere, you know, nicely written somewhere. And you have artwork and you have wordplay. So your own words and all this, when you look at it, and think about it, you will come up with some, can come up with a beautiful logo for yourself. Okay. Any comments? Yeah. So building your personal brand is really about nurturing a relationship, not just with the world around you, but it's also with yourself. And building trust and being authentic. And this is exactly what, I'm not sure who asked this question, but Aditi, is it Aditi who asked? I'm not sure. But definitely being authentic and building trust is a very important aspect of your personal brand. And seek feedback from time to time. Sometimes you may think that somebody will give you an idea. And that just comes to you because you are actually open to feedback. And which we are generally open to feedback. But yeah, so next slide. This is something which is very interesting. I just wanted to share it with you. In psychology today, there's somebody who says that, you know, men and women are wired differently from a cognitive perspective because there's a part in your brain called the corpus callosum, which actually helps you interact the left brain with the right brain. Apparently, guys, now don't take me wrong, but the guys don't have such great network wiring in this area. So you ask them to do a task, they'll go and do that, just that task. You say change the baby's diaper, they'll change baby's diaper. They will not powder the bump or whatever it is. So it's but women are more nurturing, more protective, so they think and second guess themselves, unfortunately, very often. So try to not do that. As women, we tend to think, no, because we are from a protective kind of evolutionary path. So think out of the box. And these are the steps and ladders. Yeah, that's fine. Define your X factor. What is your strength? Understand your Y factor. I mean, why am I doing? Why am I good in this? Eliminate your Z factor. That is something that is like draining. You're not comfortable with it, and go for it. So that is essentially what I wanted to share with you. And sorry for the initial glitches. Yeah, to summarize, this is a summary slide, the what and the why of it. Set goals, very important. Sometimes goals may change, but it's a good idea to set goals and nurture and nourish your personal brand as you move along. And I have references in the last slide, if I might, if Anu, you may show, and thank you so much for this task that you have given you. I'm so sorry for it, but there's a lot of wonderful references, lots of references on personal branding, but I just took a few and so that you can, you know, start looking at them. So I'm ready for any questions, or if Sandy wants to say something, or Asha, Vineet.
Manjula?
Yeah.
Yeah, so my understanding is that whether or not we go for explicit website and a logo and a signature for ourselves, it seems that just by our interactions with everyone around in the world and how we carry ourselves, we are always conveying our personal brand. Is yes. that right?
Yes, yes. You are your brand. I mean, you carry your brand from head to toe, to be honest. But
yeah.
That said, you shouldn't, you know, I always feel that overly trying to impress someone also is something which is pretty draining on my energy levels. So I try to just be me. But, you know, a groomed and a spiffed a little bit me. That's what I mean, right?
Yeah.
So it's up to you, whatever you feel comfortable. That's important.
Yeah. A very insightful session, Manjula. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for bearing with all the problems that I had in the beginning.
I think it's happened.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
So thank you. Don't log out, folks. You have to, Anu or Geeta, if you can put the feedback form in the chat.
Yes.
Please do fill it right now, because then you'll get credit for, you know, the certification. Just take a few minutes. And while you're filling it in, if you have questions for Manjula, you can talk about it too. But
yeah. Hey, Manjula, Vineet here again.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for this lovely session, Manjula. Very, very insightful. I just had a question. I think it's very similar to what Anu asked earlier, but also, you know, there's an aspect to where we are, the Jory's model, where we are kind of trying to see how people perceive us, right? And so in creating your own personal brand, which maybe to sell your services or yourself or whatever to a new company, the intent maybe to do something like that, right? What Yang called hustle in her session for the you know,
yes.
your company's brand. So how do you kind of deal with the dissonance that may come in between what you actually are as a person and you want what you want the world to perceive you as? I mean, is there a dissonance there? Won't that make you more unhappier if you try to, you know, as you said at the end, right? It drains you when you try to please someone. How do you
yes.
try to get into the trap, right? Because sometimes you just label yourself saying, oh, I am enthusiastic and I'm doing this. But that could be just you get a job or wrangle something or get a favor.
Yeah, things don't happen overnight, Vineet. Unfortunately, you know, we do think sometimes that we need to reinvent ourselves or do something different or something. I'm in conflict with what I'm portraying or projecting and what I really am. It's not something that gives you a solution overnight. But I would say that it's like navigating the Bangalore roads when you look at potholes and you try to sidestep them. You know, eventually you do get to the destination. This is what I feel, because there's no easy answer for this. It's not easy to say, of course, all of us are working not just for altruistic purpose. We also have families to run and homes to tend to. So it's a balance, if you ask me. It's wondering whether you can take this jump or you feel that you're going to, unless you take some risk, take has to be there in us, but some of us are less risk-taking in nature. But sometimes, you know, it's worth the risk. Like I think I moved out and said, this is what I want to do. And so far it's worked 7 years and I'm still there. Although I may rethink of next year, I don't know what it is, but it takes time, Vineet. I don't know if I'm answering your question right.
I got that. I think you're saying that you need to take time. It takes time to even find your own space, right? That's
yes. Yes. And there's more opportunity to find your own space now. Absolutely. Now more than ever.
Yes. Thank you, Manjula. Again, the lovely
you're
session.
Welcome. You're welcome. Any other questions?
I think there was a question in the chat that.
Is there any difference, right? Chandrika's.
Yes, yes.
In the branding statements while working for an organization and when being independent. I think I feel that you need to create your own statement. But like I said, sometimes it melds with your corporate brand. And I think a corporate brand also looks to different personal brands in its group to make itself, to sustain itself, right? So, but if you're going to be overambitious with a statement that you want to make for yourself, I would caution against that. Keep your statement simple, and so that it's sustainable and it grows in an organic manner rather than projecting yourself something which you may not be able to live up to in the future. I hope it answers your question. Yes, Johan. Hello, Johan. Please, I'd like to introduce you to him because he's my wonderful student who is now looking at biomimicry as a serious profession. Yes, Johan has a question. Nike are known to make sporting goods while Crocs are known to casual shoes. As a designer, I wouldn't want to be associated with a specific industry since I'm multidisciplinary. Yes. How do you let your audience know that you're not in a niche space? Well, you've just done that. And I think, again, a logo might show that, Johan. Creating a logo that shows a little more softness and flexibility, like the Crocs, may actually show what you are as a multidisciplinary designer, isn't it? Anybody would like to answer, Johan? Okay, we'll take that off. Yes, go ahead.
Manjul, just because I was in advertising once upon a time, I think what we do is create our own portfolios, right? I think the mix of our work also sometimes speaks to the versatility we have. So I think
yes,
and that's, I think that's what you're trying to say, that a portfolio
yes.
work from between our industries, between various job functions. Not all of us came from tech writing, right? We have come from
yes.
industries. I think that is adds to our own, you know, persona.
Absolutely.
Brand values.
But, yeah. Maybe Johan would like to meet up with Vineet and continue the conversation. That's how we build our network, right? So, yeah. Would you be sharing the info? Yes, I think Sandhya, would you like to take that question?
Yes. The presentation as well as the recording will be available on the Manage the Docs website. And when it's available, we will post it. Hope you're part of either Twin on Facebook, Twin on LinkedIn, Manage the Docs on LinkedIn. We'll be posting and sharing it in all those places. You can also look at managethedocs.org website and we'll post it there later. So yes, it will be available.
Right.
So folks, if you've finished your feedback form, you're welcome to log out. Anu, if you could just keep it open for another 5 minutes, the session, so that people have access to the feedback form. I just want to take this opportunity to thank you, Manjula, very much for making the time. It was a wonderful session.
I must thank you.
I personally would love to have, like, I think, workshop on the mood board. Maybe if people want that and they're willing to do that, we could try that sometime. I think there was a lot of this we could, you know, workshop a lot more. So, yeah.
Yeah, we can do it together, all of us. Yes, yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
We are becoming the thought leaders, you know?
Yeah.
This whole group, right?
Yes. Yes, I think that's... yeah, that's interesting to think of, is what is our brand as this group, right? As this group of leaders, not just for our own companies, but for, I think, the industry at large. Right now it's tied to a particular nation, it is for our country, but yes, I think that's an interesting thought. So thank you everyone for joining on a Saturday morning. Appreciate that.
Yes.
Hope you got some takeaways for yourself. To share the feedback form, tune in future sessions. The calendar is also always up on the website, so you can check that. And thank you, Cisco, once again. for
Yes, thank you, Anu, again and again.
Yes.
Okay,
I'll sign off. Again, Manjula, great session. Yes. Thanks.
Yeah, you're welcome. Bye.
Thanks, bye.
Can I sign off now?
Yes, Manjula. Yes, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, so for everyone else, as you have, if you're finishing a feedback form, feel free to sign off and we'll see you on another Friday.
So, Sandhya, yes. Shall we log out?
Yeah.
There are just a few people, right?
Yeah, just a few people. If they have access to the form, I hope all of you have access. Is that your real garden, Anu?
No, that's what I'm aspiring to. The garden has a real glare, which is why I don't use it. This is what I'm going for.
Yeah, that's wonderful. Yes. Mm-hmm. I remember seeing it when you just moved in. So,
right.
Been, So, this is your gardening mood board, so to speak.
True.
Yeah. All the remaining participants, have you all finished your feedback form? You're welcome to sign out. If you close the WebEx session, will they still have access